Foreign Affairs spokesperson Raul Hernandez now joins us on the line. Good morning, sir.
Good morning, Ron. Good morning.
Hi, sir. Good news over the weekend that the 21 Filipino peacekeepers have been released, but they are going back to their tour of duty there. Would you know, sir, up to when they are going to be staying there at Golan Heights or being part of the UN peacekeeping force, sir?
From the report of Ambassador Olivia Palala, who is our ambassador in Amman, Jordan, she told us that the Filipino peacekeepers will have to stay in Amman, Jordan, in order to rest for a while, and maybe after 2 days they will be sent back to the headquarters in Ondof in Golan Heights, where they will have debriefing sessions and other activities related to the work in Ondof in Golan Heights.
That's right. Our report said yesterday they are still in a hotel in Jordan. Is that correct, sir?
That's right. They're still there. They're resting, and maybe by tomorrow they will be sent back to Golan Heights and be there for the time being.
Okay, sir, but we want to ask you also, how is it in Syria? What's the situation in Syria now? We still have more Filipinos coming back home because of the situation there. How bad is it still there?
Well, as we know, and as you know, the violence is intensifying in Syria. Mm-hmm. Not only in the other areas like Homs, Idlib, Daraa, Aleppo, but also nearby Damascus. And that's why our repatriation program has been ongoing. And so far, we have repatriated about 3,692 OFWs, and most of them are undocumented back to the Philippines. We think that there are still about around 3,000 Filipinos who are there, and we are intensifying our campaign for them to go home.
But would you know how many more have already signified their intention of coming back home, sir, as soon as possible?
Well, for now, we have nearly about 200 Filipinos in our embassy in Damascus, and we are trying to get the papers so that they can immediately be sent back to the Philippines.
Okay, sir. On another issue, let's go to the Sabah situation, sir. We've, of course, received reports, and the DFA has already received reports that some of those who came back home, evacuees, have been telling stories of maltreatment by Malaysian forces, sir. And I believe that the DFA is trying to verify these reports. Have you verified this information, sir?
Well, first of all, you know, this report came to us with great concern, and for the government, this is acceptable if true. That's why what is important now is to be able to document and also verify these reports. And we have asked the other government agencies, specifically the DSWD, to help us document these stories and make sure that we are able to validate all these reports so that we can make the appropriate action.
And have you already made a formal request for clarification from the Malaysian government, sir?
We are asking our DSWD to collect the relevant information, and after that we will immediately notify the Malaysian authorities about this and make other actions that are appropriate.
But for now, sir, would you have any action plan if these reports are verified? The Malaysian government may deny these incidents. They have informally replied and denied the accusations. But if there's some way that the Philippine government can verify that these maltreatment reports are true, what would the Philippine government do, sir?
Yeah, because it's easy to deny reports if they are not verified. So that's why the first thing that we have to do is to validate these reports. Okay. And when we have enough evidence that these are indeed true, then we could launch our action and make sure that our people are treated humanely in Lahad Datu and elsewhere in Sabah. And also remember that we have been actually asking for full access of our embassy team as well as our augmentation team that the DFA sent together with other government agencies who are now in Sabah to be able to talk and look out for themselves how the Filipinos are there who are in custody by the Malaysian authorities. This is important because we would like to know if they are treated humanely mm-hmm. and if their rights are respected.
The Philippine government has been asking Malaysia for access to those detained by the Malaysian forces. Have they given you a reply, sir?
I think this is still under consideration and we are following up this request. This is important because under international law, specifically the Vienna Conventions on Consular Relations, we have this right.
That's right, sir. Okay, what's the situation on the ground, sir? Would you have any information on that? Are the operations against the members of the Royal Army continuing? Have there been attacks or the house-to-house search for members of the Royal Army continuing, sir?
Well, there are a number of reports that have reached us, but we also need to have verifications of these reports. We have our people there in Lahad Datu, but they could not go in and visit the areas in conflict. So for now, we are relying on the reports that are given to us as far as casualties and other operations and other actions from the Malaysian side, as well as what is reported coming from the Kiram group.
Okay. Assistant Secretary Raul Hernandez of the Foreign Affairs Department, thank you very much, sir.
Thank you, Ron. Mabuhay po kayo. Salamat.